Yo, easy. Hey, Davey, how are you doing? Did you make anything? Let me see. Let me see. Gold commits. Do we see Davey here? See any Davey commit here? See any Davey commit here? Nah, it doesn't look like it. Ah. Sir Clan, hello. Ronan Rue, hello. Yo, hi. So guys, I'm going to be lazy today and I'm going to stream without the camera, right? Because I'm lazy. Anyway, how are you guys doing? We're going to continue working the game. The Linksider. I don't really have a plan. I just decided to launch the stream because you know, some progress needs to be done and can just figure out what to do here, right? Here's our Linksider cargo run. Here's with the editor. Here's the game working on. Here's the level editor. We're supposed to have this level selection screen, which is level. Is that coming anytime soon, Davey? Or no. Whoa, Tired Beaver, yo. Was wondering if I should do the contest stream like you wanted me to, but I don't know where. What's your time zone and shit, you know? Oh wait, 10 push-ups? All right. Okay. I guess it will be a stream with the camera for a little bit while I'm doing the push-ups. All right. Hold on. Let me get my phone first. Okay, here we go again. I need to connect the phone first. TV. Connect. 42. 169. 42. Okay. Do screen copy. Activate Linux, but he can read chat. Can read chat. I'll show myself. Here you go. Here's my camera. This is my table. You. Hello, Nerdsel. How are you doing? Wait, what? Hammed? Disconnected? Wait, what? How did this happen again? Redo? Hold on, but how did it happen again? Why is it being disconnected? No, it doesn't make any sense. Like, why? I'm not pressing any buttons. Is it just because the Wi-Fi is bad? Okay, fine. This is the only time when I do the push-ups twice in a row. Even although I already did them. Okay, did it work this time? I think you have seen everything. Okay. Done. Easy. Easy. So this means that since I did 20 instead of 10, the next time someone redeems the push-ups, I can just ignore it, right? Right? Okay. We have the new style already in your branch. Maybe you didn't push your branch. Why is there no branches? Oh, wait, this only shows me the commits from the main branch, right? Level design? Oh shit, look at this! New commits. This was 1 week ago. Did I not merge it yet? Okay, get bull. This was 1 week ago. How did I not even merge it? Should I merge it? Merge level design. From the origin, yeah. So, what the fuck? Merge conflict. In tiles, yeah, sure. Both modified. Accept both changes. I mean, what I want, I guess, is jump effect active should be from here and push from your. Right? And LS tiles. How do I accept all incoming, right? So that would be Davies. Okay. What's going what was committed there? Do you know what was done there? This looks like the previous. No, where? This one, the level selection world, right? This is how the level selection world is going to look like, apparently. Hmm. Art style. Yeah, it's going to be a different art style for the level selection screen. Level and the world label or text. Why not the icon though? Instead of a text. Wait, where is the overlay? Icon. Hold on. There's the overlay. I mean, it's not scary after the first time. It was like you need to wait a little bit that the people are not prepared for the jump scare, and then you jump scare, you know? I'm supposed to just do 3 jump scares in a row, guys. Okay, what am I supposed to do here? Okay, Davy. We need... Oh shit, this is laggy. What the fuck? Why am I missing the disabled buttons? Because you didn't enable them? Did you draw them? Did you put them in the... the thing? Here. Disable. Wait, home disabled, redo disabled. Okay, the buttons are here. No data for rendering jump side effect active. Or jump side effect boost. That's a different thing though. The disabled button is a different thing, right? It's like over here. Over here. Magnet side effect active. There is no... No. Hold on. Hold on. Disable. Undo disabled, for example, right? At 10:13. Wait, how do I... You said it is like undo disabled 10:13. It's an invisible. That is why I don't see him. The disabled buttons is over here. It is invisible, Davy. That's why we don't see it. Let me save this file. Unless I merged it incorrectly, did you have it drawn? Yeah, there you go. See, the button is there now. Disabled. I have a different tile set. Maybe you only enabled it in the level selection. Levels selection tile set over here. Is this the one? Because we have now 2 tile sets, right? Okay, this one is wrong. Okay. Okay. Hold on. Git checkout. Git checkout origin / level design. And from there, I'm going to check out the assets, the game style. This how it's supposed to... Okay, this looks like... Yeah, okay. I don't know what happened. Did something wrong? When merging it, maybe? Okay, there you go. We have the disabled buttons now. Button is disabled. Here I can redo. Undo. Okay, the disabled button should probably not be hovered over, right? So it should not be scaled like this when it's disabled. One of the things. What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this, Davey? We have a check mark. When this thing is do the UI overhaul sometimes later? I don't know. You don't like the UI that we have here? I think it's okay. Not the worst part of the game. The worst part right now is missing of the level selection screen since we deleted the old one. Okay, so the problem is that over here you have... Wait, hold on. It's... So the problem is the pixel density needs to be changed. All right. Didn't we say that it should be only changed for the PC and for the mobile? It should be the same as it is right now? Or no? I don't know. We're okay. So did I do something wrong again in merging? Let me try. Check out config. What is... No, this is the only line. The jump side effect active. Oh, wait. Jump side effect active. Yeah, you just don't have it. That's why. You can specify a different sprite for the active side effect that is not, that is like, so sometimes it's pushed but not active, you know? So for an active one you can do a different. So I guess we should just so I go for all the pushed ones, then I copy paste these lines to be active, but you can change them to be in different sprites. Make them the same for now. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Yeah, also these visual effects are still temporary here, I guess. Hold on. When it's on the left side, you see the pushed button over here on the left side. When it's on the right side, I don't see it. Why? That's the active particle? Yeah. You can have the particle effect for your stuff. So you have over here and the active effects, and you have all the sprite sheets for when the side is active. That's what I did for the active magnet, but better than that, right? Why did I not see it on the right? That looked like a bug. Fix. On the top, I do see it. On the bottom also, see? Like, I see the button on the top, but not on the bottom. Like, why? Now I see it on the right side. Now I don't see it at the top. Is it RNG? Let me see where I am drawing those. That pushed. Here. Calculating. How much are we pushed? Probably not equal to 1.0. If I add epsilon here, that how we fix this? By maybe there's just some, because I'm literally comparing for equality with 1.0 here. That probably which actually means that I should over here check stuff equals to 0. Check for something else. See, it worked now. Looked like it did work. Okay, I think that's the problem. So pushed equals 1.0 is going to be fully pushed.
Hi,
Pigorley. What are you doing? Fully pushed. Fully pushed is pushed more than or equal 1 minus epsilon, right? So it's like equal to 1 or almost equal to 1. That should be. Fix the merge. Fix fully pushed buttons. Decision error. Name sprite for active effect for now. Okay. Here you go. Yo, by the way, we need a goal that doesn't require current rotation. There is no rotation difference of player in level selection. Well, yes, but in the level selection, the thing is not a goal. It is an inner level, which is a different thing, which does not require your selection already. It's not a goal because it's a teleport into another level, right? And it is called inner level over here. It's just right now we're using the same exact sprite for that inner level. I guess The goal makes you go into another world. No, it is a different entity. Goal and inner level, they are different in the level editor even. Goal makes you finish the level. Inner level makes you teleport into a different level. Goal makes you go into another world. Isn't that similar? Though? To teleporting into a different level? Because you can have, for example, you can have a level in the regular level set, which is going to have like a secret position, which contains the inner level. So like you can finish the level, or you can instead go and teleport into a different level to solve some other secret level. That's one of the examples, right? But the goal require rotation right now, right? The goal, yes. The inner level doesn't. They look but you don't want it to be a goal. Right? Over here, if you have another thing over here, if I rotate myself differently, I can still go into that level, because this is an inner level, it's not a goal. That's what I'm talking about. Different world is not an inner level. Okay. Should I just rename it from being an inner level into being a teleport? Because it can teleport you into whatever you want. It can teleport you into a different world, into a different level. Well, I guess inner level is something that you can go back to when you press escape, for example, right? But for a different world, if you press escape, it should not. Is it possible to get a girlfriend as an Arch user? I thought you were a Mac user. Didn't you buy yourself a MacBook recently? So now we know why. Because you struggled as an Arch user. Is that right? Still new. Yeah, you can ask a girl if she can help you with using a Mac. I guess that's how you get a girlfriend or something. No, I'm not the one who to go for advice. I think, hello, Infinite Coder. Okay, Davy, what should I be doing right now? Optimize is blocked. Do I want to do optimizations? I'm too lazy. Blocked levels. I don't know. I'm going to postpone this. Show level index and level preview. Okay, you want me to have this text. Okay, that's why you're not working on the new level selection. All right, fine. I will do this for you, but I will make a new issue where we change it into an icon instead of it being a text. All right. Show level on level preview. We can do icon, why not? I don't know. Why do we even need an icon if we have a preview of the level? Isn't preview enough? I will draw the text if I want it to be text later. Yeah, that way you can also control the this way you can also control the font, right? How often do people surf in Russia? Like surfing? We have a surfing after, like, I did see people surfing when attached to a boat, you know, and surf, like, behind the boat on the waves that the boat is making. Does that count as surfing? Because you need like the waves, the big waves, to do the surfing properly, right? We don't have that because, I mean, this is you do, but it's called parasurfing. I say that counts, all right. I tried Geng, I want to use it for my overlay, but if you want it to be if I want it to be interactive, I will need to reopen the window. It's only possible if you implement this. Run return. Why do you need to reopen the window? It doesn't make sense. Because you want to change the interactivity? Or what? The level index so player knows what level it is. We want the level index so player knows what level it is. The preview isn't hard to tell. Two levels are different when you only see the preview. Goggled wake surfing, parasurfing, surfing, but for disabled people. So what about the level index being, instead of the index, the icon? Do you remember that stuff that we had? Hold on, my Discord is not opened. What if we use that? Oh wait, David just pushed something. Oh, not pushed. A goal that doesn't require current rotation. To kind of name the level. Yeah, the icons, we already had it, right? The instead of it being 1, 2, 3, we want our own secret code. Because I think it is going to look better if we use these numbers, right? This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, 7, 8. Nine, 10. Right? But if you use this, is there going to
Can
be a
chat, please?
Group with more than... Reopening window is necessary to reload dynamic Hyperland window rules. Why don't you make them dynamic Hyperland window rules? Looks like an issue in Hyperland, not in Ging. Okay. And the problem with those symbols is they don't communicate well for players. When you see level 1-1, you know exactly you are in the level selection screen. Okay. When is the text? Level 1-1. Okay. Level 1-1. I mean, hold on. This is but these are the numbers, right? It's just a little bit of a puzzle and figure out these numbers. But it would be exactly the same, no? Also, where are we supposed to have these numbers? So you want two things. So the world text in the bottom of the selection screen. So what is the current world? The worlds are going to be numbered or what? And then the level index on the preview. And then inside the level, you want both the world and the level then. But where? If this is the level, where do I put the this text on this UI? Check the mockup. Where's the mockup? It's not going to always just work though. Also, it looks like the font should be different. It's right there. Is this the one? On the level index, on the level preview, I don't see it. Level 1-1, I don't see it. So, okay, over here, for example, I'm showing this text, right? So you want me to do something similar like this, but instead it would be when we're playing, it would be on the bottom over here, stage 1, basic move. Number zero. Is this the actual... Number five issue? No, it's not issue number five. One, two, three, four, five tests? What do you mean ongoing issues? Oh, they're on the demo milestone. Going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm supposed to like count. There is a number over here. It's issue number 118. You don't have an example of showing the world and the level index inside the actual playing of the game. You don't have it here. You only have the mock-up of the level selection screen. Under the level selection screen. You don't want it to be on the actual level. On the level selection screen. Mm-hmm. Okay. Hold on. Yes, you don't need that on the actual level, I suppose. I don't know, why not? If you need it there, why don't you need it on the actual level? I think it should be there. I just don't like the text. That's my only issue here. Let's start with the text, so that at least something is... So I want... I think... my levels to be configured. Here's our level selection group. We have override tile set, override background, and also I want you to be able to configure whether or not this stuff is visible, right? So show level is you've seen those level label means you're in the level selection screen, not in the level. Also, the background means that those things. I don't know. Your level group, Rust. Able the above, hello there. It is Rust. This specific file is a TOML file though. Here's the Rusty object notation though. And we're going to write actually some Rust code right now. Go level. Okay, I want to be able to configure for all the level groups, whether or not we want to show the levels. That's it. There you go. Levels. Group config, it's going to be over here, show level, show level, so show level is either group or level or group and level or none. Okay. How am I doing? I'm doing okay. How are you doing? So this means that for nothing is just nothing. For group, it's just going to be group. For level, it's just going to be level. For group and level, it's going to be something like group level, right? That's the difference. Because we right now are grouping, like we have groups and levels, right, inside the group. That's what we have. So for your level selection group, you would want to show the group name, right? That's how you would I'm doing good toast on the stream to watch while I do OS dev. OS dev. Sounds nice. Group, level, group and level. That makes sense? Only public. All right. So when I'm doing the playing over here, when I'm doing the draw, yes, it is after I draw everything, right? It's just on the top. The operating system is definitely nice to work on. It sounds like an interesting project, but what is your goal with it? Because I'm assuming you're doing it just for fun. I think it is a fun project. But at the same time, I can't really see me doing something that is going to actually be used by other people, so... Unless it is for fun, I don't see other reasons, to be honest. I have the loftiest of all goals, use it. So you wanted to make it for yourself to use?
Hello, CEO. You wanted to see me?
Igorly. Are you the CEO now? The CEO of Pushups or what? Okay. I'm being called out. Oh shit, Brainoid. No way. I haven't seen you in a while. How are you doing, Brainoid? Was on vacation? Nice. Nice. What was your vacation? The more I work on the... while you were on the vacation, we were working on this game a little bit. And then the more I work on it, it looks like the progress is being slower and slower. Movie works. Sometimes. Or... times
work. Can you rechat, please?
Right, hold on. Go. Some good friends on the vacation. Oh, went to see Dan. Want to see Alicia? Did I lower the cost to do the push-ups? Yes, I did. Because no one was redeeming them. I want to do the push-ups, you know, to to be distracted from what I'm doing all the time. Yeah. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Okay. By the way, we recently tried the music. I think I didn't reply to you about the music that you tried making for this. I thought it didn't match the game, like, at all. Lower the cost to 1. Per crab push-up stream. I don't actually know, like, how much push-ups can I do in a row? I never tried going for a maximum, right? I think I can do like 50, but I am not sure. It has been a long time since I actually did that. I was more of the pull-ups, you know? I was doing pull-ups, not push-ups. 250 right now? No. Yeah, also, I think, Davey, about putting the game on Steam, I actually think that we should rethink the strategy here. How about we make the game first so that it looks good enough for us to be put on Steam, and then we figure out the details of putting it, and at the same time, like, polish this thing even more before actually putting it there. Rust King, hello. Wanted to make a good game the first time. Should have applied WD-40. What is WD-40? You can increase the contract trust. Oh, I see. Yeah. See what you're saying. Okay, so what are we doing right now is I'm trying to make the text for the level that we are in. For all the level groups, I want to configure if I want to show the group, the level, or both group and level, or nothing.
Picorly. Hello.
Oh my god. If I'm going to be this slow as I am, like, working on this project when the LD is going to happen, I'm going to end up without a game, you know? Why am I so slow when we work on this project? Why? Could we remember how to make games? I'm not sure anymore, I'm not sure. We need to go, like, the LD is in less than 2 weeks now, right? YQVY. 17 days until the LD. Is there the theme voting for it yet or no? And does theme suggestion need to see start? What is Ludum? It is the Game Jam. One of the oldest ones where you need to create a game in a couple of days. So that's what I have been doing a lot. Is all of these games that you see on my each page are all the Game Jam games. So this Linksider game that I'm working on was originally made for the Bevy Jam in 9 days. Most of the other ones were made in 2 days. We're participating in Mega Jam in 2 days and I still haven't received my GPU. Oh shit, from the last Mega Jam? Yeah, so the last game that we made was this one, The Snaked, right? That was my last. For the GMTK? Yeah. This is what we made in for the last gem. Wait, so you're going to do 2 gems in a row? It's going to be Epic Mega Gem and the LD then, right after? It's a snake game, but I'm playing as this little smile here. It's a game where you're trying to not get eaten by the snakes. They are going to be hunting me, like over here, you see? Oh shit. Okay, there you go. I died. That was the last game jam. So it goes like this, if you never saw me doing a game jam. It is going to... It is going to be the theme revealed when the gem starts, like in 17 days, we're going to know the theme and we're going to make a game that applies to the theme. So for that snake game, for example, the theme was reverse the roles. So it was a snake game, but instead of you playing as a snake, you were playing as food. That's the idea. And for this game, for the Linksider, for the game jam, the theme was side effects, so this is why we're playing as a cube, and we can attach the side effects to our sides. It's like jump effect or magnet effect or other things. Okay, and I was doing a rendering of the current level. Okay. You made them in Rust. Yeah, everything on my itch is made with Rust. And I'm using my own game engine too. Although the one time I did not use my own engine was originally for this game, the Bevy Gem. We used Bevy, but then I have rewritten this game from Bevy to my own custom engine too. Hello, Cage. How are you doing? You win your thing with the OTK stuff or no? Last time I saw you, you were telling us that you submitted your project to this thing they were doing. They activated the keys last night. Okay, so this means that they have tried playing your game, right? Soda Poppin played it for 5 minutes on the stream? On stream? Or... Wait, is Soda Poppin part of the OTK? I joined the VC when Kuvi was playing a game on Discord. When? Yesterday? I mean, not yesterday. On Sunday, we were playing the Don't Starve. Were you listening to us? All right. He was the hee-hee guy. All right. Oh, so you are in the Discord. I was thinking about like asking you when you want the Code Forces stream to happen. I thought you were not in the Discord, actually. I guess you are. So your name is Coder on the Discord, right? It's you. Coder is an LTK. Okay. Okay, let's see. Self, context, gang, default font, draw. Okay, so I'm going to draw using the UI camera. Using the UI camera, the text is going to be dependent on let's see. That text, probably a cow string, is going to be match self group get config code level. Okay, so if we are doing nothing, then yes, it's going to be an optional string. Okay, so over here it's going to be nothing. If it's group, then it's going to be some self. Wait, I don't know the current group name here. Do I? Maybe the name should be in the group itself. Group. It's level, then we do sum. Do I not know the current level at all? Level, optional level, location. Oh, yeah, no, we have the location. I just think that the location is not being saved. That is it. Okay. Location. Okay, fine. So then it's just going to be self location group. Over here is going to be a location level. And if it's group and level, then I need to do a formatting here, right? Format. This location group. Location level. Okay, then we see if we want to draw some text. So if this is sum, then we are going to draw it in the bottom of the screen. The alignment is going to be center aligned, color. Show level color. Transform. It's going to be in the bottom of the screen, right? Actually, you know what? Let me just do the position here. 0 and self to level position. Show level color and show level position. This is going to be a vertical position. I'm not sure about the position yet. Yeah, that's why I mean, it's going to be in the middle. Horizontally, it's going to be in the middle anyway, I think. It doesn't matter. It doesn't make sense it to be on the left or on the right. Because the text is always horizontal, right? It's either at the top or at the bottom, I think. I'm going to do the configuration of the vertical position here. Okay, so I'm going to do show level color is going to be white, and show level position is it is in the UI FOV coordinates. So if the UI FOV is 4, this means that the bottom of the screen is -4. I guess it also should be size, right? Show level size is going to be like 1. So I think something like -3, 1. Maybe. That's probably it's going to be too big. See if it's going to work. Okay, so it's supposed to only be in the level selection over here. Yeah, so over here, this is showing this selection because the group is called selection, right? So if you're going to make another world, it's going to show here something else. This is literally the name of the group that I'm showing here. And if you were to, for example, this over here, I have this show off group for showing off stuff. So I'm going to have here show level. It's going to be group and level, right? I think this is how I did it. So in this group specifically, if I play this, it's going to show both. Show off one, right? But it should be the level name, not the group name, I think. Okay, fine. You can change it to be the... Okay, if you want to have the level selection group and you want to show the name, then you just instead over here change this from group to level, and it's only going to be the level. So it's going to show world one now instead of a selection, right? So you can configure it whatever you want. You can show the group, the level, or both. So now it's going to say world 1. There you go. Okay. So this is showing current group / level. Configurable for every group. It should be good enough. And then for the visuals, I guess the font at least should be changed. Okay, and then you want to show the level index on the level preview, right? On the level preview. The level index. Loading something here. So when we are inside the level selection level, is going to be this one over here, right? You are here. Then want to draw. Like above the preview, the level that we're going to teleport into. Right? Okay, so what are we teleporting into? Sometimes we're teleporting into the inner levels, and sometimes we're teleporting into other worlds, right? So like on the edges of the screen, we look. Can I change the label color? The one at the bottom, this one? Yeah, sure. No data for rendering jump side effect pushed. There you go. Hello, Ricky. If we look at this new level selection mockup over here, right? So you have the level one over here, right? These things, this is level one, this is level two, level three. This is locked level. This is locked. But this is also a teleport. So I guess several teleports here. We should be able to configure the teleport icon here, right? Because left and right means going into the previous world or into the next world, right, Davey? But those are still just teleports into a different level. Is this the transitions that you imagined? Oh, no, that was the preview showing. That's not how we show the preview right now. Do you still want it to be shown like this? I don't know, this looks a little bit wrong. You edited the issue, by the way? Where? This one or some different one? You can use that as a transition. Yeah, I guess we can. A tile same as inner level tile, but does not show the preview. All right. That's not the only difference. The other difference is that it has a different icon. This one has the icon left, and this one has the icon right. So are those different entities or same entities? So I want to have basically is it can be just rotated? Yeah, I guess it's okay. Okay, fine. I guess it can. But it still is going to be the inner level. I guess it would be a good idea to rename it at some point. Now, weather. I'm going to instead. Let's see. So the inner level right now has the position and the group and level that we're teleporting into, right? And we want to have some configuration here. Just like for the entity, we have the configuration. The identifier is here. And for the inner level, it's going to be instead bus mode, inner level mode. So it's either an inner level or the next level, I guess. I don't know. So this is supposed to be not an inner level. It's supposed to be like teleports. Not sure if I can easily just rename it though. Ten push-ups. Okay. Go. Okay, by default, it's the inner one. Here's to do rename to level the port or something. All right. Okay, for inner level over here, I'm going to match inner level node. So it's either an inner level, then we draw this tile, otherwise we draw if it's the next level. Yes, you can just, I guess it can be just the icon for the next level, like this. Doo-doo. Okay, inner level mode, I think, just do like this. So we're going to have two tool types. One of the tool is going to be inner level, and one of them is going to be the next level or something. And that's it. No, I have inner level. Note. Match mode. This level. This. So the mode. Just here. And over here, I'm creating the inner level and the next level tools. Then we have here you go. Inner level. Next level. Real art. Yep. Okay. And then we also want to change the behavior of it to not show the preview. That's the only other difference, right? So the next level is not going to be shown the preview, or the preview is going to be shown somehow different. I don't know. Maybe a different kind of transition also can happen there, right? And other things. So you're supposed to have over here world 1 and world 2, right? Actually, hold on. Let's delete world 2. And let's copy-paste CP2. World 2 is going to be here. Oh shit, I panicked. Oh, you're not supposed to do that, I guess. You're not supposed to drag and drop into the plus sign. Okay, that's all right. That's okay. Here you go, world 2, world 1. Let's change this a little bit just so that it is different. Right. And then over here, I want to have this level tool should also use the tile set that we have for the current level, right? It's currently a little bit confusing, but this is the goal. This is the inner level, and this transparent thing is the next level. So I'm going to draw the next level over here, and it's going to be selection world 2. Netcoder, thanks for the raid. So here you go, this is the selection world 2. This is stage 1 basic move, right? So now when you are here, you're going to see the preview here, and you are also, I guess you are not going to see the preview here, because that's what is going to happen. Next try and bring more. What? We really need the name for the tile in the wheel. Yeah, I guess. Where do we show the name though? I mean, you are the one who's using the editor, not me. I just see that this and this looks the same in the default. And that's the only problem here. And also we have a couple of tools here which don't even have the visuals over here. What even was here? I don't remember. In the middle? I thought the preview was shown in the middle, but I guess not. No, the preview is shown over here at the top left. Did a run return, but I will still need to fix multiple event loops issue. I am not going to ...100% merge your issue, no? There are other issues with the run return. From what I remember. Your delay is huge. Yeah, I think your stream was also very laggy when I clicked on it. Fiddle on top of the wheel. Okay. Next level, no data for rendering. No data for rendering. Okay, but hold on. This is us having the thinner level modes, right? That they can look different. And you can, I guess, rotate it too, right? I didn't try rotating it, but I will have a fork never only able to use. Yeah, sure, you can have it. To, I don't know. We can make it an optional feature. I'm just like, you know, if I merge it, then I will need to maintain it too, and then it will probably break at some point. That always happens with all of the features in Gang already. Bam, bam. I also just realized, yeah, you can have this arrow pointing up. So from what I... see, there is a problem. If I do Alt F4 over here, because I have unsaved changes, it will go into ask me if that I have unsaved changes. Do you want to exit? No, right? But if I try playing this level, and then I hit Alt F4... I cannot even... wait, hold on. I cannot even Alt F4. Okay, I guess... No. Is it because I exited this way? I'm not sure. Want yo exit? Is that what it's saying there? Want yo? Yeah, I guess that is actually what it's saying. Yo. Yo. Okay, there we go. I fixed the typo. Okay, let's fix this the tool wheel in the level editor to use this overridden tile set and shit. So, level source editor level here. For game tile. Draw game tile. I'll literally something that I don't want to use here. Draw game tile is here, here, and here, and here, and here. Bam. I want to use a... so draw game tile always draws using the default tile set, but we can override the tile set here. The tile set is going to be overridden. Type. Tile is just going to be overwritten. Type draw. Group handle. We literally have the override tile set here. Optional and override background too. Do we have the background also? The changed background? Level editor, we replaced the background with a plain color.
Draw game tile.
Okay. Draw tile instead. Draw tile takes an additional argument, which is the tile set. The tile set is going to be self group get override tile set as ref wrap for default is here. This is not the optional. Add another draw, or maybe hold on, draw game tile. This is used in other places too. Deprecate it. I don't want it to be used. Well, this one I'm going to call this bold. Is going to be actually draw game tile. It's going to have the tile set. It's going to be optional that we can override. Here we say override tile set wrap or the default one. Tool type. Group. Group over set. Self group get override that as seraph. Okay, I think this should be it. So now inside the level editor, our tool will in the icons, the actual tile set that we're using to draw them. So for example, in this level, right, we have our player replaced with a kick W. So in our level tool, look at this. The kick W's are all over the place. Nice. And in this level selection, here's what it looks like. The player, this is the teleport. Teleport, like these two things are using the same icon still though. Use override tile set in level editor. Okay, that's the thing. And then also, Davey wanted to for me to just the tool The tool should just have the name there, right? So tool type function name self is going to be a string, right? That I can Well, I mean, technically, there is the preview tile name, right? Literally the tile name that I'm using for rendering. How about we just use this stuff? Because that's all we really need to. Okay, here we're drawing the tool wheel itself. I guess it does make sense to draw it in the middle. I'm just going to say that if item is hovered, then I'm going to draw the name, right? Item item tool tool type preview tile name. This is the name that I'm going to draw. Default form draw. For drawing, we need a frame buffer, we need the UI camera, we need text, this thing, we need alignment. Also need the transformation, going to be tool wheel position. We have the center. Doot. Preview text scale. for the jump scare. Okay, so in this tool wheel, we just have the name here in the very middle. It is a little too small right now, but I mean, it fits. I can change this. A little bigger, I guess 0.2, twice as big. So over here, the tool wheel, player, disable box, cloud. Disable box block player in goal. Create jump power up, magnet power up, weak magnet power up. Does not have the icon, and the next level, and then the inner level and the goal have the same icon over here in the deep. Yeah, there you go. Okay, showing name of the tool in the tool wheel. There you go. There you go. Okay, well, a little bit of progress has been made. Now, we make more progress is the question. I guess this one, show level index on the level preview. Is we are going into the inner level here. Did I like the pizza? Yeah, it was better than the other one that ordered the barbecue chicken. And the other one that we ordered was just mushrooms and vegetables. The barbecue chicken was better, yeah. I guess I'm not going to ban you after all. Suggest. Is the best piece? I'm not sure if it's the best. I'm pretty sure that, like, I wanted to... I mean, I think I misclicked. The other mushroom pizza that we ordered before was better. There's like... In the place that we order, there's three different pizzas with mushrooms, and they're like, I think the mushrooms and the vegetables was the worst one of them. Still pretty good. Tommy, Selma, hello, how are you doing? Okay, we want to draw this over here, level one. Ba-dum. So we're here. Review. So I am standing on an inner level. And I'm going to draw the preview here. The inner level, although, can have the mode, which is either the inner level or the next one, right? So yeah, going to do match inner dot mode. I got a Taco Bell commercial. Clicked on the stream. No, maybe it was because we were talking about pizza. Hold on. Is the ad engine that they have on Twitch listening to the stream? Because we were talking about pizza. That's probably why. You know? Or is Taco Bell... I mean, still like food related, right? Fucking Taco Bell. We don't have Taco Bell in our country. So I don't really know about it. So what we want, sometimes we want to show the preview and sometimes we want to show next. What country am I in? I am Russian. I am still located in Russia. We need an exit strat. I'm just too lazy for any strats. What's the problem? Okay, so if the mode is the inner level, then I'm going to show the preview and I'm going to show the text. And if it is the next, then I'm going to not show the preview and only show the text. I think eventually we can do something else. So if we are showing the preview, then I'm going to do this. To McDonald's, you by the trash and knockoff. Like a yummy mouth. Yeah, they basically, it is basically still the McDonald's, but I mean I tried it once or twice. I was not like doing McDonald's a lot before. I'm not sure if the quality is any different. Does it taste same? Like, I'm not the correct person to answer because I have not tried. I was not ordering McDonald's a lot before. Anyway. Last time I was there, I just ordered a coffee. So, I don't know. How about Coke? There are multiple different variations of Coke now, but I think, yeah, depending on which one you are trying, it's taste more or less like the old one. They're all slightly different, I guess. Anyway, I'm not doing much Coke anyway, either. No? What I'm doing most of the time is just sitting in front of my PC and drinking some tea. That's it. Sometimes we order pizza. Do they drink in Russia? What do you mean, what? I like the black tea with mint, but we drink sometimes black, sometimes green. Yeah, add some different things to it. Like mint is one of my favorite things to add to the tea, and then also hold on. Use the Google Translate. The current leaves, I guess. English is pretty good. Yeah, I guess I I was learning English for a long time. I only started actually talking English though when I started streaming. So only for a year I have been practicing talking English. But before that I was, I mean, pretty much everything I'm doing in English. Like if I watch a movie, I'm going to watch it in English. If I'm watching, if I'm reading something online, I'm going to read it on the English. The only thing I do in Russian is talking to people that are living. And it's like a BlackBerry. British people like it. Yeah. Yeah, the berry. The current, exactly. But not the black one, I think. The red one. I'm not sure. I'm not sure actually what it is. But I think... I'm not sure. I think the leaves, they still are kind of... they have the similar smell anyway. Because we're not putting the berries themselves into the tea, right? But the leaves. The only thing that I heard about the British people and the tea is that they like tea with milk. Do you like tea with milk? Because that is disgusting, in my opinion. I like coffee with milk, but not tea. Thai and Indian tea with milk is the bomb. Maybe it does depend on the tea, and no. Maybe we cooked it wrong. Okay, if show text, then I'm going to do something similar here. Self context king default font draw. So the text is going to be the inner location, right? Inner location. Let's see, inner level align. Center. Transform is going to be the same. Oh, it's actually not going to be the same. Yes, over here it's going to be 2.0. When are we going to switch you to Vim? It's time. I mean, I can switch right now. I have tried Helix. I like Helix more than Vim now. But the problem is that they don't really work well with Rust Analyzer for me. If you fix them for me, then I can switch. I'm not sure what the problem actually is. Donor view was doing fine for Rust for me. Color. Show level color. This, I think. Whoops. I'm sorry. It's proven using Vim gives you plus 10 intelligent points. But I'm already using Rust, which gives me plus 100 intelligent points. Like those 10 intelligent points that I get from Vim, like they are not even necessary at this point, like since we're already using Rust. You know? You know, Haskell gives you plus 1,000. You want me to write some Haskell? I thought about trying O'Camel instead of Haskell. But, just to, like, try it for a little bit. Must is an awesome weapon that requires 12 intelligence, but you rolled it via Scout class, so you only have now. Now you can probably wield it. Alright. Orkan Lick Cider gives you negative 999. Yeah. I don't know. I think it's just working on the project for a long time. That's the problem, you know? Like, usually, before Linksider, what did I work on? The Linksider is literally the longest project that I have been working on. Except for the engine, I guess. But the engine, I don't really support it that much, right? I'm not really working on it. I'm working on it, like, one week a year or something. So yeah, Linksider is just the project that we have been working on for a long time, which is that I'm not used to. But as long as we're making a little bit of progress every day, we're going to... That's all that matters, right? Just make a little bit of progress every day. Next thing you're going to tell me you are developing on Windows. Nah. Hold on. Actually, yeah, we are using NixOS, which means that is like, even though I'm using VS Code on NixOS, that still gives me plus 1,000 points of those of intelligence, right? Have you tried NixOS yourself? It's not even Arch, you know. Like, if Arch is plus 10 points, NixOS is literally plus 1,000. This definitely this does more than just compensates for the VS Code. Yeah, I should do GFO sometimes in between. Yeah, maybe. What is NixOS? So you haven't even heard about it? It's the operating system where you configure it using Nix programming language, which is like Haskell but worse. It's like a language for configuring. So you make your system configuration declarative. Or language development. I don't know. What should I do? GFO or language development? Maybe both. I should do both. That would be too many projects, though. That's why I wanted to, like, focus on just the Linksider. But yeah, sometimes you just want to get this to be distracted. I guess the Ludum Dare is going to be there for that. On Manjaro, go ahead and do your worst. Oh shit, Manjaro. Manjaro is literally like, if you say that VS Code, I mean, Manjaro to Arch is what VS Code is to Vim, basically. Go level review size. Go level size, level review size. Okay, let's try it. You just convinced me to do RMRF. You don't need to RMRF. You can just install Arch or Nix just next to your existing Manjaro. You don't need to delete what you're doing right now and then install the new thing immediately. You can do a smooth transition from one thing to the other. Scale uniform around. Round one. Okay, scale uniform. What I want, the uniform scale by this size. Okay, be good now. Can you throw up a screenshot of a mock-up of something? What is a mock-up of something? What is it? Oh, you want to me to show you my game? It's going to be shown right now. It's going to be not just an image. It's going to be, here's the loading screen. Here is the level editor. This is the world editor where you can see all the levels. Here's the actual game. And like, this is the simplest level. Here's the a little harder level. Did me graphics and shit. I'm working on this game together with Davey. Davey is doing level design and graphics. I'm doing the codes. So right now I'm working on this. We have this thing where we can see all the levels, but this is the in-game level editor basically. And for the actual players, the level selection screen is going to look like a game itself. So it's going to be like this. So over here you're going to basically select your level by moving around these levels. So like we're going to have levels inside levels like this. So this is a teleport into this first level in the game, which is called the basic move. And we just go inside there. Who's Davey? He's over here. Okay, basic move. There you go. This is going to be like a mobile game. We're going to it works on the web, on the native builds, and on the on the Android right now. It doesn't work on iOS yet because I don't have an Apple, but because I don't have a Mac, I guess. Probably we'll figure that out at some point. iOS sucks, fuck them. Yeah, maybe we just say fuck the iOS. If you want to play the game, just buy an Android device. Or, I mean, yeah, I think we are going to release it on Steam and on the Play Store. Maybe on each too. But not a lot of people are using each for games. And just a bad Linux distro anyways. Well, technically, I like iOS more for their... I mean, overall, I like it less. There is one thing where I like it more, which is the choice of a language. I really hate the fact that Android is working on top of Java. That is, that means that... I don't know. I don't like it. But those small features like adjusting the volume of the apps individually, I don't even know about those because I'm not using iOS anyway. Well, anyway, you wanted me to explain to you the mechanics of the game. You have your player is a cube, and on all the four sides of your cube you can have side effects. Over here, this green one is the jump side effect, which makes you jump. And you also have seen on this level, right, This is the slide effect, which makes you slide. And there is also the magnet effects, which makes you magneted. And there is the disable blocks, which makes you disabled. You can have the boxes that you can push around. There's a different mechanics. If you want to try out the game, we currently have the old version of the game hosted on itch.io. Over here is the link. That version over there is old, though. We're trying... Yeah, it's a puzzle game. We basically made it for a game jam originally, and now we're trying to make it a full game. So, like, things like undoing and redoing, for example, were not there in the gem version. So, over here, I can just move around, right? Hello, Bad Cop. Thank you for a sub. You want to link up with someone to make a game? I suggest you do the game jam. Hold on. So, over here, for example, we have this undo and redo commands, right? And this is the reset button. So this was not there, for example, in the gem version. And like over here, we have the in-game level editor. That's going to be there in the full game. We're going to polish the in-game level editor more so that people will be able to make their own levels inside the game and probably share it with other people too, you know? Yeah. What else? Also, like, originally it was made in Bevy, but now we use our own custom engine for it. We changed some of the game mechanics since the gem version. But, the gem version is still fun. You can play it if you want. And if you wanted to link up with someone to make a game, I suggest you participate in a game jam. If you... you know, whatever about game development, the Ludum Dare game jam is starting in 17 days, and I'm going to be participating in this one and a bunch of other people from chat too. We're going to make a game in 2 or 3 days. There's multiple categories there. It'll be so soon. Yeah. All right, let me do the push-ups. You are not ready? I'm not sure if I'm ready. Like, yeah, I'm not sure if I'm ready. Should I do a preparation streams for the LD? I want to change something. And I want to try and remember how to do those multiplayers. Because when is the last time I actually made a multiplayer? It was a long time ago. How to join the game club you just mentioned. This is the LD Gem website. This is I mean a lot of game jams are usually happening on the itch.io, which is nicer in my opinion, but this one is like one of the oldest game jams. So the website is a little weird, but just register there. And if you want to find other people, then I'm not actually sure how you can join the oldest and most senile. What does it even mean? What does this even mean? Big brain streamer. That's me. Alright. And yeah, since Pigorli is redeeming those push-ups basically every half an hour, I'm also going to be the big muscle streamer soon. Okay, let me fix this a little bit. So this this stuff, we have the basic move here, and it is Wait, hold on, David, do you want me to show you the index, the number of the level without the name? What do you want me to show here? This is going to be the world one. You want to try and make a game with people just for fun? You should probably maybe tell what you want, what you are, what is your part in the team is going to be, and maybe there is actually someone in chat who wants to join, some random person in chat. I'm pretty sure I will do the LD solo this time though, but that's how this game started. We joined with Davey, even though we never made a game before. Join me, a random person. Yeah, but like, what are you using? What game engine you are using? Are you an artist or a programmer or something else? Sometimes maybe there is someone here, and if not, that you can try joining the one of the many Discord servers that do the game jam stuff. Or there is the unofficial Discord server for the Ludum Dare game jam itself. Have you made other games before also? If you can link to your other games, would be nice to take a look. I can just change the name of the level to have the index, I think. Who, me? Yeah, you. If you want to make people games with other people, you want to like advertise yourself so that other people want to work with you, right? So just tell them about yourself. What can you do? What have you done? You never made a game? Made bots and AI. Well, I mean, you made something very small that resembles a game. Maybe you made a World of Warcraft computer vision based bot. Nice. Nice. Okay, you can change the name of the level to have index, you think. Yes, but do you want that? Because this naming is more descriptive for you to work with. Wanna check it out? If you made a video or something, check it out quickly. Mm-hmm. Not sure how else would I check it out. You can post in chat whatever you want. If someone joins the chat and puts the bad link, we just ban them. That's how it works here. So yeah, show the actual index. Yeah, for example, over here it says selection world one number zero. So what does this mean? Number. Who do we ban? Mm-hmm. Me? But how do we work on the link cider if we ban you, though? Do you want to work on something else? Like, what are you doing right now, Davey, anyway? Selection level. What is the selection? Inside the level editor, right? Hold on, is this level literally just called basic number 0? Is that why? Well, stage 1. Basic move. No, it's not. It's just... Do you want to do ILD with me? Don't think you can handle even installing Unity. You can reboot into Windows if it's still hard to do on NixOS. You'll have your Windows there, right? What was I doing? Alright, I don't know. Today is so lazy for me. Even lazier than usually. Don't have much space there. Just delete something. For you, what was I doing? Over here, I was showing the text. There you go. 0.5. You deleted something to update Rocket League last time I booted? Well, I'm pretty sure Rocket League is working on my Nix though. I try, like, all the games that I have tried so far have been working very well. Like, I have played Apex on Nix, I have played Factorio, Counter-Strike, Don't Starve, Celeste, right? Everything works easy. Use mods. Do the mods not work if you use Proton? Because, I mean, it's just launching the Windows stuff anyway, right? Maybe you can still use the mods. No, it's just like in a different path or something. Too lazy to figure it out. Okay. I am going. The thing is, Davey, I'm not sure how to get the index. Do I? Yeah, I don't think I can even get the index here. Easily. Because we don't have the entire group loaded. We don't have the list of the levels loaded. We only know that we're pointing to that level specifically. By game bot.
Hey guys, welcome back. We're going to be looking at our navigation bot for World of Warcraft. So here I've got my bot open
It's looking look at these top wobbly windows. Is this KDE? That is KDE.
See here, I just have a screenshot. So it's looking for this navigation beacon. It's found it. So we've got our location. This is all the work that we did last time. It's got our location and it's got the percentage match. In this case, it's not exactly 100%. That's because I'm using a screenshot, but that's okay. So it's close enough that it's able to find it. Now, what's new is we've programmed it so it's able to detect the angle of our player with respect to that navigation beacon. So, for example,
this is 27 minutes. If I move this over, geometry. Oh, look at this. Look at this. What application are you using here?
Geometry lesson here, refresher.
What is this?
Unfortunately, we got
Sornal plus plus.
A little bit of geometry. So if this is my screen,
looks nice.
And I have
we draw here. Although I don't really like these lines. If I would, like, I would delete these horizontal lines. This just makes it look like an actual.
We can imagine that our screen has a center point. And of course, this is our player. I'll draw our player here in black. So this is our player. He's standing there.
Yeah, like an actual notebook.
Thank you.
But I don't like
now,
that.
Now, we want to calculate the rotation of our player towards that target.
But I like the way things are being drawn here. I usually use paint for it. Okay, some geometry lessons here. Okay, I thought this was AI, but you actually do some, like, geometry. Oh, shit. The delta W. All right. Move.py. All right. Some Python. I heard Nursel likes Python. That's old school AI. Yeah.
Last video.
There you go, Nursel. Some Python special for you.
So make sure you do that. The parameter will essentially be a time, and it will be the file that I'm going to call nav.py. Nav.py is going to contain a lot of the navigation related functions that we're going to be using. So I've got nav.py created here, and this is where we're going to be doing our.
All right. Inner previews. No. Okay, hold on. I'm loading the levels. I'm loading all the levels here. Group. Load. All right. You know what? I'm going to rename this into inner levels. I'm going to have inner level here. I'm going to have level. Preview is texture. Inner level. Preview. It's just I not only want to have the preview, but I also want the index here. So, and the index is going to be group.levels. Iterate position. Position of a level that is equal to inner level, right? There you go. So the inner level should also have the index. Then I will be able to draw the index. Of making games just ruin other games, lol. Is there a terms of service for the World of Warcraft where you should not be allowed to actually run the bots so that you don't ruin the game for other people, right? So technically, is this thing that you are making actually a bad thing? It's like making an aimbot for an FPS game, right? I thought it is actually like Hold on. I guess it's not exactly the same. Aimbots are fun. Yeah, but you are ruining the fun for other people. No? Those that are trying to play the game normally. It is a fun project to make, I am assuming. But at the same time, it is bad, and people who do that should be punished. I made a phishing bot for WoW. I had one person message me that they were disabled. And really appreciated it. Yeah. I don't know. It's a little bit different than the aimbot. Right? I guess in WoW you don't really ruin other people's experience too much by providing this tool. But if you were to playing Counter-Strike with an aimbot, then you would definitely ruin other people's experience. Okay. I think if it's going to work, I'm just going to end this. I don't know. I'm so lazy today. I don't know why. Okay, so we are here. Am I on top of this? It's going to say level 1 because this is a level 1. And if I am going to have another inner level, but I need to know what the other inner level is going to be. Basic move, basic rot. Okay. Basic move, basic rot. I have another inner level here, which is going to be stage 1 basic rod, right? So yeah, over here you don't really see the preview, the index on the inside the game. So this is going to be level 1 and this is going to be level 2. Go level index on the preview. Container level. Okay, done. Davy, done. It looks ugly, but it is done. Alright? It looks ugly, but it is done. It means that it's better than nothing. Go level index on preview. Probably something like level 1-1. I'm currently drawing just level 1. Should it be like world 1-1? I don't know. I mean, I wanted to have no text. That is my opinion. But I added a little bit for you. So, yeah. Does gang support fallback fonts, for example, for emojis? No, I did not make support for emojis. I did not make support for emojis. What happens if you... Well, hold on. What happens if you actually do that? It's just... It just doesn't draw it. Because there is no rendering data in the font. That emoji. Okay, guys. Okay. Going to end. DJ is now streaming too. Okay, I don't know how many Russians we have in that. We raid this person who's doing Rust development. Russian. At least two. Or we just end the stream. It's okay. I don't want to think about it. See you guys next time. Today was a lazy stream. Hopefully next time is going to be. I'm going to be less lazy. Bye.